I'm here with Suda51 and his translator, Alan. I'm sure you know Suda51. He's a pretty prolific game designer and director. So we're going to talk about his history and stuff like that. So just to begin, his new game, No More Heroes, Travis Strikes Again. It's not really a character action game like I kind of thought it would. It's more of a co-op, top-down brawler, sort of. So what made you guys want to do that instead?
Travis Strikes Again について、したいんですけれども、以前のノーモンヒルズと違いまして、キャラクターアクションというよりも、ちょっとトップダウン、ブローラー的なものにしたい。なぜ今回それを作ろうと思ったんですか？
今回は、ナンバリングではなくて、新しいニュー IP として Travis Strikes Again を作ってるんですけども、希望的に、これまでのノーマーのスタイル、ゲームスタイルを使わずに、もっとよりコンパクトなチームで、インディーサイズの中で、で今回も実は任天堂のインディーズのブランドを出してるんですけども、いわゆるインディーズとしての新しいチャレンジを、このノーマーヒーローズのシリーズを使って、やってみたくて。で、ゲームプレイもそうなんですけども、すべてが新しい形で挑戦したかったんですよ。
So yeah, that's a good observation. As you could tell from the title, this is not No More Heroes 3. This is actually kind of a new IP, a new direction for Travis. And what we're trying to do is with this, we're looking kind of more for an indie spirit, meaning the team is much smaller than it's been up until now. And so in order to kind of facilitate that indie spirit, as well as to best utilize all the members of the team, we thought this would be a better way to realize that, which is why it's going to be like you said, kind of a top-down brawler.
Yeah. Okay, cool. So I actually played a little bit with him the other day at Nintendo's HQ. It had sort of a meta, like PS1 level, like presentation over it all. Can you kind of describe the inspiration to that?
Yeah. 幻のゲーム機があって、これは実は世に発売されなかったゲーム機なんです。で、なぜ世に発売されなかったかというと、遊んでしまうと、いわゆるなんていうかな、パワーグローブ的なものをつけるんですよ。そうすると、完全にゲームの中に入ってしまう。だから、危険なゲームだからこそ発売できなかった。で、その時のために用意されていた、6つのローンチゲームの中にトラビスは入って戦う。で、当時大体それが1990年代初頭の、ゲームハードなんですね。そうなると、時代的にはやっぱ4対3のアスペクト。で、そのゲームの中に入ってしまうということで、そこに対して忠実にデスドライブの世界観を作って、で、その中にトラビスが入っていくという、そんな流れになってます。
So, actually this kind of touches on the story. So, what happens in No More Heroes Travis Strikes Again is that Travis actually gets this like mythical console called the Death Drive Mark II. So it was kind of released in the early 90s. And this was a console that never actually went to actual retail sale because it used like these special gloves that you put on. And when you put on the gloves, you actually entered into the world of the game. So as you can imagine, that's a very, very dangerous thing. For launch, there was 6 titles planned for this console. And Travis has managed to get them all. And so when he puts on the gloves, he enters into the world and he gets inside the worlds of the game. Again, because this is a console that's supposed to be from the early 90s, the aspect ratio is 4:3.So it does have a very 90s feel, which you correctly pointed out.
Cool, awesome. So since it is a different genre and something that you haven't really done before, what other games did you look for inspiration, like for the gameplay side of things?
So, じゃあ今回はいくつかのゲームでできることですので、他のゲームはどこからインスピレーション取ったんですか？そういう6つのゲームを。
いろんなゲーム、僕が子供の頃に遊んだ記憶だったりとか、あとは、過去のグラスホッパータイトルの影響もすごくありますし、あとはその具体的に大好きなゲームがあって、それがすごくモチーフになっていたりとか、本当にいろいろな形でありますね。
Tons. For example, some of them are from games I played when I was a kid. Others would be from past Grasshopper titles that I've just been playing overall. Can't really pinpoint anything particular, just tons and tons of games that I've played.
Okay, right on. That's probably the best answer. It's coming out on the Switch. No other platforms announced for it right now, right? No More Heroes originally launched on the Wii. So there's a Nintendo through line here for this series, especially this series. Why stick with Nintendo again? I mean,
Nintendo Switch のみの発売となりまして、もちろんNo More Heroes 1と2は Wii ですね。このシリーズは
Nintendo Hard Series みたいなことになってるかもしれないですけれども、いやいやなぜ Nintendo さんに転がるんですか、こういうシリーズに関しましては。
ノーマンヒーローズと Wii がやっぱりすごく相性が良くて、まあそれはコントローラーもそうだし、Wii だからこそ、Wii の中ですごく成功したタイトルだというふうに僕自身も感じていて、だからこそこのシリーズを復活させるには、やっぱり任天堂プラットフォームがすごく一番適していると思ってるし、あとファンのみんなからすごく要望が強いんですよね。で、Wii U が発表された時も、ノーマンヒーローズをぜひっていう声がすごくあって、だからこそ、やっぱ任天堂の新しいプラットフォームができるたびに、僕の頭の中でも、ノーマンヒーローズシリーズを復活させるっていうイメージが出来上がってくるんですよね。まあ、それぐらいすごく、まあ、ノーマンヒーローズシリーズと任天堂プラットフォームっていうのは、多分相性がめちゃくちゃいいんじゃないかなと思います。
The No More Heroes series just kind of fits. I mean, if you look like you said back to No More Heroes on the Wii, the controller was perfect for it, what he had in mind. And so using that functionality really made for a great game. And in the same way, as soon as he heard like a Wii U was announced, he thought fans were like, oh, you should make another No More Heroes. And he said every time the Nintendo makes a new hardware, he feels like it would be good to bring back No More Heroes, and he's always wanted to put it on there. Another thing too is that for this time, with it coming out on the Switch, this was the perfect opportunity because obviously they ended up skipping No More Heroes for the Wii U. But overall, just No More Heroes and Nintendo platforms seem to have a really good, they sync up really well.
Cool. So, wait, you said the Wii U. So, was there any plan to bring this to the Wii U? Can you like, delve into that a little more?
で、結構その、なんていうかな、三部作じゃないんですけども、シャドウ・オブ・ザ・ダムド、ロリポップ・チェーンソー、キラー・ゼットって、まあ、ある意味三部作なんですけども、これにずっとこう集中してたので、なかなかその Wii U のプラットフォームに入ってくるタイミングでなかったんです。
So, that's, the Wii U era was when we started working on Unreal 3, using the Unreal 3 engine. And, you know, there's, I guess there's a, you could almost call them a trilogy of games. You got Shadows of the Damned, you got Lollipop Chainsaw and Killer is Dead. We were kind of focused on them, so we didn't really have an opportunity to kind of look to move the Wii U and do anything for it. So that's probably why we didn't do anything on the Wii U.
Okay, yeah, that makes more sense when you put it in perspective like that. I didn't think about that. So speaking of Shadows of the Damned, it's my personal favorite. It's right above Lollipop Chainsaw for me. yeah, I'm one of those guys. So I guess with the perspective of what, like it was like 2010, right? That was, or 2012 or something, right?
Yeah.
So now that we've had a few years to kind of look back on that, how do you reflect on looking, making that title, especially with the, what was it, Akira Yamaoka and Shinji Mikami? That's a dream team of Japanese developers. How do you look back on that title, like both good and bad? Because I don't know how well it did it or anything, but I know it reviewed pretty well. So how do you look back on it?
で、まあ、その開発について、ちょっと、まあ、いい話、悪い話、ちょっと振り返ってみると、どう思いますか？
やっぱりすごく楽しかったんですよね。まあ、特に三上さんと久々に、まあ、キラセブン以来、久々にプロデューサーとディレクターで、一緒にこうタッグを組んで、で、要は、プロジェクトの立ち上げから三上さんも一緒だったんですよ。要は企画を持って北米のパブリッシャーに回るツアーがあったんですけども、まあ、その時に三上さんも一緒に同行してくれて、まあ、いろんな、まあ、最終的には EA とか作ることになったんですけども、EA 以外のパブリッシャーにも三上さんも一緒に同行して、だいたい北米10日間ぐらいですかね、いろんな場所に回ったんですけども、まあ、その旅もすごく楽しくて、二人でずっとギャグを言い合って、で周りがみんな笑って、まあそういう旅がすごい思い出深いというか。
It's actually a lot of fun. Because I remember, you know, this is the first time that like, Mikami-san and I worked together as like the producer-director tag team since Killer 7. And, we had made the concept for this game first. We actually went to pitch it in North America. So we came here to North America, went to about 10 different companies to pitch it. And I remember he says it was great because we would like have all these gags and jokes that we'd be playing. Actually, people would be laughing. It turned out to be a really good trip, and it was a lot of fun. So really great memory.
Good. I'm glad you reflect positively on that experience. Because, yeah, I really liked that game. So I'm glad you liked making it, too. So going to the other extreme, Killer is Dead is one of your titles that doesn't seem to have gathered as much of a positive response from the fans. Do you have any memories of that? Do you have any like regrets or any sort of general reflections on that game?
ああ、思い出は、いろいろあるんですけども、やっぱ、キラー Z はすごく難産だったタイトルで、最初のプロトタイプを作ったんですね。それはもう、一つのステージ、いわゆるボスファイトも全部出来上がって、ある程度一つのゲームとして完成したんですけども、一回それを捨てて新しく作り直したっていうゲームなんですね。なので、なんとかすごく、
So that was a game that we actually ended up having a complete kind of working prototype of it from you know the stage to the bosses and everything. And we ended up having to throw that away for various reasons and kind of start over and rebuild it from scratch. And so in that regard, it was a game that had a really difficult birthing process and we went through a lot to get it out. That said, I still am glad that we were able to bring it out and get it out there into the world.
Cool. So even in the lower parts, it's good to have that positive looking back experience. It's good. And speaking of positivity, I mean, this is just my projection, but Killer 7 seems to be like the highest of your fandom. Got pretty some red fans for that game around there. So it's the remaster's coming to Steam. So I'm going to split into two questions here. Sorry. Is this coming to other platforms eventually?
キラセブンはもしかして、あの、スーさんのタイトルの中で一番もう、ファンがもう本当にハードコアで大好きな、あの、愛されてるタイトルですね。で、今回は、今、Steamと発表されてるんですけども、Steam以外にも、考えられるんですか、この、ああ、まずはSteamで出すことがすごく重要で。
今回は特にゲームキューブ版のポートなんですね。当時ゲームキューブとプレステ2が出て、だけど PS2版は移植なんです。で、裏ソッパーがオリジナルで作ったのはゲームキューブ版なので、やっぱりそれを多くの人に遊んでもらいたいという思いがずっとあって、だけどなかなかそういう環境がない中で、まずはカプコンさんからSteam版作っていいってOKをもらったので、で、僕らはミサさんと組んで、ようやくこういった形で実現することができたんです。
So the thing is that at the moment it's only planned for Steam, and so we'll see how it goes after that. But one of the reasons we did this too is because we at Grasshopper made the GameCube version, and the PS2 version is actually a port. And probably most people are more familiar with the PS2 version, but we really wanted people to play the GameCube version, the one that we made. And so actually the Steam version is completely based on the GameCube version. So that's one of the really big reasons that we wanted to revisit this project. And of course, we talked to Capcom, we got the permission and things like that. And we worked with NIS America to publish it. We'll kind of see how it goes in terms of what's next for it after it comes out on Steam.
Cool. So I guess that maybe just answered what I was about to say. So is this like a prediction of what, is this like a hint or a tease of something else? Are you guys like putting out the feelers for maybe not a sequel, but Killer 8, you know, I don't know, something like that. Like, I guess I'm just asking like, what is this looking forward to, I guess?
これは、成功したら、例えば、続編とか作るとか、そういうお考えがあるんですか？もちろん、カプコン次第っていうところはあるんですが、ただ、僕の中でキラー7も完全燃焼してるゲームなんですよね。当時のスタジオであり、僕自身もそうなんですけども、すごい曲面的な状態で作っていて、すべて出し切ったものがキラー7なので、続編っていうのは、やっぱり頭の中にない。
Honestly, obviously, making else would depend on having a big discussion with Capcom. But beyond that, this is a game that myself and the team in the studio that we were working at, we put everything into it. And we really believe this game is complete as is. It's got everything that you know to complete it. And we, honestly, I don't really know that I could make a sequel to this.
カプコンさんが許してくれるのであれば、いわゆる完全版は作ってみたいです。要は、なぜかというと、僕の脚本ちょっと書きすぎてしまって、3分の2ぐらいカットしたんですよ。そういったものを全て再現する形で、本当の意味でのキラー7、誰かがファイナルカットって言ってくれたんですけど、そういったものができるんだったら、 実現してみたいなという気持ちはあります。
So, rather than a direct sequel, what I'd love to do is actually make a complete version of the game. What I mean is that I might have wrote a little too much when I made this game because two-thirds of the script that I wrote ended up being cut from the game. And so someone we've been talking to mentioned maybe like a final cut, and he said, that would be wonderful. I'd love to do something like that. That would be kind of the dream for this to succeed.
Oh, that's interesting. I didn't know you had that in mind. That's about all the questions I had today. You guys want to let me know anything else? Like, any... It doesn't have to be specific, just whatever.
まあ、まずはね、これが、まあ、キラーセブンがあって、トラビス・スラックス・アゲンあるんで、まあ、この T シャツも実はいろんなヒントなんですよね。
Yeah. Nice. Oh, it's like, cool. So as you know, Killer 7's coming, and then after that, Travis Strikes Again is also coming. And in terms of hints,
I don't know if you guys can see, but the T-shirt that we're both wearing here
actually might be a hint for something in the future. Who knows?
I don't know. What could it possibly be? All right, well, that's about it for us. Michael from Game Revolution, and thanks for watching.